Hey everybody, this is Jerikos.
And this is Jerikos' wife. Welcome back to Wife Wednesday. We're working on Lego Star Wars. Currently we're finding all the minikits.
Yep. Making our way through Phantom Menace, I don't know what things are called. And on to Attack of the Clones. Let's hop right into the first chapter.
So for this level, we decided that since there's stuff throughout the level, we're just going to play through the whole level and show you what we're doing as we go, instead of cutting back and forth like we have the last couple of times.
Yeah, it gets a little easier to follow in this level if we do it that way.
So one thing that you're going to want to do is shoot these light columns. See, that was 1 of 10.
Yeah, they're pretty big and easy to see. You'll find 6 in the first area, and there's going to be 4 in the second area. Basically have to destroy them all. You also have to destroy all of these gun turrets that shoot at you. Now we already destroyed all 5 of those in the story mode, so I'll try and make sure we grab them all, but almost missed it. Right off the bat, TIE fighter door to the left, and a minikit. So are you stuck in there?
Yep.
Let me get you out. So we've got a few more. There's another gun. The minikit detector is really, really nice on this level because it tells you as you're getting close to each of the light columns.
It's also useful to have infinite torpedoes turned on because you need torpedoes.
Yeah, one of the ones we're going to be doing requires torpedoes in a sec. In fact, I think...
there was another of the guns.
Oh, did you get it? Nice. I forget where it is exactly, but there's definitely a skyscraper that requires torpedoes. Let's go around this one.
What is this? Torpedoes.
Oh, this is the thing. This is what I was thinking of. I'm stuck. There we go. Yeah, you
have
one
of them.
Okay, let me come around to where you are.
There we go.
All right, okay. We have to destroy all of these blue antennas on top of this building.
Go up.
Oh, we're coming down.
Okay.
Yeah, because we're looping around this building here, and 4, 5, and where's the missile? Where'd it go?
5 of 5.
There we go. That was awkward. Infinite torpedoes is wonderful on this stage.
Yes, it makes a very big difference.
Yeah. So, another
one of these.
If we can hit it. I cannot shoot it. Okay. Try flying away from it for a bit. Turn back around. Got it. This is an awkward stage. I mean, don't get me wrong. I like it. But it's really awkward. I think we might have missed one. Let's come back for a second. And... yeah.
The arrow.
There it is.
That's 4 of 10, so there's still 2 more.
Yeah, and I see 2 arrows pointing up, so it should be those. Yep. That one, and
I just got 4 or 5 or something too.
It was the guns shooting at us, and there's the last one. Now, real quick, before we go through the tunnel, come back this way. We did this in the story mode. If you shoot the traffic light, it will actually cause. I think we've already done it, and that was the trolley that just went by. But a car, it changes the traffic. Vehicle drives by and you get a minikit from it. So now we're going to cut into the force field area.
And we're back. So there are these red squares on the floor which you want to shoot.
They're kind of hard to see.
All of them, but if you just shoot for a while, you'll do it.
Yeah, eventually they'll all be hit and destroyed. Oh, and there it is. Another one we got in the first time through. And there we go. So rather than bore you with this tedium of trying to get out of here with our torpedoes, we're just going to cut until we're outside of the force field.
All right. So when you get out of that area, the first thing you want to do is make a right.
Yeah, you make a hard right. I made a little too hard of a right there. Off to the right here, and should be. Well, 2 things. First of all, the TIE fighter door, but also more guns that shoot at you. Yep, you've got to take them out again. 5 in this area as well. I seem to recall we were shooting them and we missed one when we came through story mode. So.
That sounds right to me.
Yep. So we keep flying around and we should have make it. Oh, good. We did actually get all six. I had a second of forgetting if we managed to grab them all. So, I think we got one behind us here. Let's see. Aha! Gotta hit these triangles. Okay. I forgot which vehicle I was controlling for a second. There we go. Yeah, you basically gotta blast those triangles to bits. And we got one more light back this way. I can't tell where that arrow's pointing. It's that red arrow down at the bottom.
I can't tell where I am. There. I am. Okay. Red arrow.
Yeah, we keep coming down. And I want to say... There it is. Good shot.
Thank you. Oh, and these.
These were the power brick. Yeah.
Yeah. Thank goodness we don't have to do those again.
Yeah, no kidding. I'm switching around to a clone fighter because it's just easier to control than the TIE fighter. And another guy shooting at us. 3 of 5. Oh, there it is.
I got 10 of 10s.
Minikit!
Yay!
And we still got some people shooting us. Okay, they're farther up. I can tell because the arrows are pointing to move onward. So here's where we go. Okay. I forget that this tunnel here doesn't actually just take you instantly to the next area. Like the first tunnel does.
Yeah.
Alright, there we go. And let's see, we got one last one here. I think it's just another one of the... Yeah, you shoot up all the red squares on the floor. Get rid of these turrets that are attacking us. I can find the red squares. They're so hard to see. Yeah, it's pointing to where it's going to appear. Let's see. Keep shooting eventually. Oh, we got it.
We hit it somehow.
Yeah. Anyway, now to get out of this level. I mean, it's fun, but that's one of the weirdest levels for hunting minikits. What did we actually unlock for this? It's probably Zam Wessel's car. That's gonna be my guess.
Probably. I think you mean airspeeder.
Yeah, flying car, airspeeder, whatever it's called. There we go.
On we go.
So, right at the start of the level, we're playing as father and son, right from the end of Return of the Jedi. Kind of morbid. Pop that on, and can we get there? No, right, we actually have to use a high jumper to get up high enough. Who do we got? Oh, yeah, I feel like these guys should be high jumpers. Maybe it's just me.
I feel like they should be something.
Yeah. They're really just nothing.
And I have a carrot.
No, I have a carrot.
Oh.
You're a droid.
Never mind.
You can have my carrot if you really want.
Aw, thank you.
All right. Fly over here, and the minikit was originally in here. Easy one to get in story mode. To the next one?
To the next one. Alright, so once you get to this area and you make all the things light up, instead of going to the left to move on, you go to the right.
Yep, and we'll have a door we couldn't get through before. Bounty Hunter. How appropriate that it's Jango Fett opening the door this time.
So cool.
Now, we've actually got a couple minikits in this brand new area to get. And we gotta go as a team. There we go. Because each person holds down a button for the other to appear. I could show an example of what happens if I, like, moved off the button before she landed, but that would be mean.
That would be mean.
I half expected you to do it to me after I said that.
I seriously considered it.
Alright. And go. Pop open these. It's also kind of cool that you got some just, you know, studs hanging out here. But we're not done in here. Are you... I was going to say, are you over the platform? Do you want to do the honors of opening up the back wall?
Sure.
Whoa. Ah! Jango fall down, go boom. And...
Okay. My depth perception is off, apparently.
That's okay. At least there's no, you know, penalty for falling down. Okay, I'll shoot it.
Yeah, that would be good.
Oh, this thing only has a zapper. There we go. Opens up a bridge, and we head on in here. Smooth. So, with these, you step on a switch, and, well, usually, you step on a switch and it lets you crawl through a spot. Let me just see if I can... Oops! Well, they're self-destruct! Oh, no, okay, I see what it is. I step on a switch, or I crawl through, and you step on the switch to let me out. That's what it was. There we go. And then it closes down. So you actually can crawl through each one until you find the right one. I want to get free! I want to be free! Okay. We won't show off all of them, but it's kind of funny that, you know, it locks you in and your partner has to release you.
Yep.
So, moving onward to an area with less falling.
Alright, now we're gonna go this direction.
Yeah, the way that Tonway wanted us to go. And much like the very first chapter we ever played through, just trigger all six of the lights and you're good. Next, we're gonna head on into Jango Fett's personal room. We'll see you over there. Alright, so made it into Jango's room. Got a couple of these security droids, whatever you want to call them. And we've got the dispenser in the back. Now, we already grabbed this in story mode, but what we gotta do is just trigger the switch 4 times, and it eventually gives us enough stuff to build this painting on the wall. Which I gotta say, Jango's a little full of himself. It's not building, it's force. And there you go. And that normally would have a minikit hidden up in here that we already grabbed. So, let's chase Jango down.
So, once you chase Jango a little bit further, you come to these little circle areas.
Yeah.
And if you stand on the matching ones...
that line up with the ones on the wall. There we go. We did this in story mode. I don't think we realized what we were doing at the time, but we managed to do it. And that gets you one more minikit. I think now we gotta... Yeah, we're chasing him outside. So, right outside. I remember this one. I can get it! I can make it! I died again. I'm a ghost, and I died again.
Smooth.
Yep. You can make it, baby! Make it back safe! Okay, good. Yeah, you did a little better than I did with my mad jumping skills. Oops. You know, I was thinking, I'm fine. I won't get hurt by the bomb. I forgot that the floor falls out below it.
That!
Speaking of the floor giving out.
I think my button got stuck.
Probably. Go. Blow that up. And chase him around. He'll eventually go over that way. We go to the right. Yeah, we couldn't do anything with this before since we were playing as the Jedi. But if I can get the right droid, 3PO it up. And now, okay, shoot these as we go. Missed one. Yep. We gotta hit them all as we go. So. Okay. Let's see if we can't.
Hey!
We fell off!
You pushed me.
I think we pushed each other because we both went back. How about this? I'll let you hop on alone so we're not fighting each other for it.
And I did not succeed.
Alright. My turn to try?
Your turn to try. About to say, maybe don't use a carrot.
Yeah, I would say, I can do it with the carrot. Got it.
Yay!
That opened up the minikit. Alright, one more to get, and we basically have to chase Django back inside to get it. Alright, so we blew up the Dark Force door that's on the left in this room. This is the room where all the gun pods come swarming at you. And a little hidden area here. Kind of love the aesthetic of this cool little creepy clone room.
Yeah, it's cool looking.
Thing. Oh, we had to turn them at the same time. Ah! It released them.
And that's 10 of 10.
Very nice. Take a look at what vehicle we unlocked with this minikit collection. Yeah, we had almost none of them before. Is this? Oh, yeah. It's the little starfighter that Obi-Wan uses.
Cool.
So, onwards to the next stage.
And we're now in chapter 3. So the first one, you want to just come straight towards the camera.
Somewhere over here. There we go. Yeah, kind of counterintuitive. You don't think that you need to walk towards the camera. Oh, lights. Oh, what just happened? All right, so the second one is, oh, right here. Oh, that is the second alcove. Yeah, it's the second alcove that's on your right. So that's it for the first room. We'll kill a few of these bug guys and meet you where the next minikit is. Ah, there we go. Okay, so this is actually one you have a very limited time to get. As soon as you enter this area, you have to jump to the left and use a short character to climb on up. I guess you could say it's technically missable. So. And now we just follow the conveyor belt on to the end of this section. Oh, I fell.
You could probably jump back up here and go back to the previous room.
I wonder.
And get the ledge to come back.
Let's see, can we? I'm curious now. Oh, yep, you can. Okay. Oh, but the ledge doesn't come back.
Oh.
Oh, oh. Actually, yeah, this is all in the name of science. I must know. I don't think. Oh, okay. With a really good jump, you can make it.
So, if you missed it and you don't want to save an exit.
And you don't apparently even technically need a short person.
Yup, there we go.
Alright, now we're going to move on.
So once you get down here with the fans, go this way.
Spin the platform around.
Oops.
I did not do that on purpose, I swear.
Yeah, I was just kind of standing in an awkward place, I think.
And grapple up. Shoot the target with your carrot. And then an Imperial. Who do we have? Oh, well, at least you can get through the door. And now, oh yeah, here we have to actually, believe it or not, it's a puzzle. You have to trigger only the correct ones. How do you know which ones? Well, it's colors. That's really all the puzzle is. And all right, you want to hit the blue one? See if it'll let us do both together. It will. Nice. And I'm guessing green will be the last one. Troids in unison.
Alrighty.
Nice work. Such a hard puzzle.
Yeah, that was really difficult.
Moving onward. Alright, so after a little bit of misadventures, we're in the next area. This one is actually normally just right here. Yeah, it's just sitting in plain sight.
We've already gotten it, though.
Yeah. And then, oops, wrong droid. Where is R2? Oh, because it's this R2.
Go through the R2 door.
Yeah, here's another one we already got. And you just ride your way all the way to the back. And there's where it would be. Grab that money. You can do it. I believe in you. Made it! Yay! All right. To the next area.
To the next area. So once you get to this room, which is where you found 3PO and the story mode.
You just grapple along and you get it right here. I mean, simple enough. You really can't miss it, considering you have to move the grapple characters along. So, to the next.
To the next. Okay, so while we were killing some Geonosians, I accidentally already destroyed the gate. But basically, there was a little gate of bricks in front of one of these holes, and you just use the force, make some platforms.
And jump on up. You can do it. Oh, almost got it. I think you might have to push. Do you push forward to it? Okay. Oh, I barely made it. It was not letting me get up at first. Apparently, you just had to hit it that one sweet spot.
Yep.
So, onward to the next. So we've made it past the pit of despair, as I'm calling it, given how many times we died in story mode. And right around the corner is the minikit. Simple enough. And we're going to go into the last area to get our last minikit. Okay, so, and now in the final area, use the R2 panel there, which causes this platform to appear. If I can build it, there we go. There we go. Okay, you want to hop on? And I believe should just be able to high jump to it. Perfect. Last minikit of the stage. I don't even remember what we build with this one. I actually usually remember them. Oh! A droidica.
That's cool.
Yeah, it is kind of cool. Also, we're now over 3.1 billion studs. What are we ever going to spend it on? Repairs to the Falcon.
Yeah, that's probably what we need it for.
Yeah, probably more than anything else. This is going to be another one of those interesting ones where we go through and we're just going to play the whole thing, like collect all of them in one go with no cuts, because it's all in one room. There's not really any point to cutting.
This is one of my favorite levels of LEGO Star Wars, actually.
Me too.
It's just such a neat concept.
Yeah, it's like wave after wave of enemies, and you have objectives. You have to free each person. If you're hunting minikits, the easiest thing to do is not free Padme. Because you can kill off all these enemies so they stop giving you a hard time, and you just start collecting things. So, shall I go for the first?
Yep.
All right. We just hop up and hop up again, if you can actually make the jump. Go. Got the first one. And then, a little tricky, hop toward the screen to get the second one. And then, we keep going to the right.
And we both use the force to open this gate. This is one that we had already gotten.
Yeah, nice easy one for starting out. And you don't ever have to go to the center, which is nice. You just keep going around, and we come along here. We'll grapple on up. This is another one. We already got both of these. Yeah, these two blue minikits you saw up here were... Or, blue minikits. Blue Lego studs were originally the minikits. And we just keep going around the circle, and we keep finding more. What happened? I disappeared.
Camera wonky.
Okay. So...
So now we head toward where Obi-Wan is.
Yep. And just keep going around. We go. Now this, we actually, before we go up and grapple, we want to make that lift. And
then grapple here.
And I should have, who do we have that's an Imperial? If I can find somebody. Okay, Emperor. He'll do. And one minikit, and another.
And for the second one.
You can get this one with a high jumper, but it's easier to use the lift. We got almost all of them. Keep going around. We've got this spot right here where we need to build the ramp. And switch up to a little person.
Goodness, so many characters.
Yeah, way too many characters. But crawl through. And you're trapped forever. You can never get out of there.
Or just press the button.
Oh. Well, yeah, that too. And we got almost all of them. This one over here, the last one, well, actually, I guess second to last one, was we actually got it in story mode, but we didn't get it the right way. You're supposed to... can I please use the force on the right piece? Okay. Let me switch to a different character, because I'm trying to use the force on... We're supposed to use it on this one on the right first. There we go. It wasn't letting us use it. Okay. You have to build them in order. Makes the minikit appear. Now, we did something you're not supposed to. We kind of tricked it by riding up and grabbing it that way, which is not what you're supposed to do.
You're actually supposed to use dark force to make these platforms. Then you become a high jumper.
There we go. And coming up this way to grab it. So, yeah, we kind of cheesed it a little bit.
So there's really two ways to do that. If you're having trouble with one of them, we recommend you try the other one.
Yep.
And then the last one is just kind of hidden in plain sight.
Sort of, I mean.
All the way over here.
Yeah.
And you get behind this platform here.
And that's 10 column. Of 10. Platform, not column, platforms. Whatever they are.
You know, things are called things, and it's just... So that's how to get all the minikits in Chapter 4.
Yep. And it builds a Republic gunship. Pretty nice. Getting closer and closer to maxing out that stud meter.
On to the next chapter. Alright, so now we're on to Chapter 5.
And you are flying downward for some reason.
Yeah, well, you know, it seemed like a good idea at the time. So this is another one like the pod racing from a couple episodes back where we had already pretty much gotten all of them. And they're really, like, most of them are pretty easy to find.
Yeah, there's a few of them that are, like, hidden behind walls that you have to bomb, but they're really obvious where they are.
So rather than describing how to find all of them, we're just going to link to the episode in when we played through in story mode and found most of them. The only one that you need to get in free play is this one.
Which is a TIE
Fighter
door.
TIE Fighter door, and you fly on through.
And there. You get that one. Yeah, just so you know, there are, other than this one, there's four more in the first area, and then there's five that are all around the big control ship in the second area. So, that'll do it for this one, so we'll pop on out of here. And we're back. You know what? I got this in story mode. Do you want to get it and, you know, bravely sacrifice yourself? Oh, well, that's no I thought you were about to sacrifice yourself anyway.
No, I survived.
And the second one... Right off the bat, you just grapple. I love that we're both Count Dooku in Count Dooku's stage. So.
Ah! Okay, there, I sacrificed myself. Do you feel bad?
Much. Thank you. Oh!
Oh
I can watch
I
this all day.
I keep slipping. I can watch this.
I'm just going to sit here and wait. Oh, she figured it out.
Oh!
Falls flat on his face.
You know what? I'm gonna slap you for that.
Hi. Can't slap me. You don't have super slap.
Okay, on to the next area. Alright, so when you get to this little antechamber, just use the force on these thingies.
And blow them up. Simple as that. We got that one in story mode. Oh, sorry. I thought I was doing something with building that was on you.
Yep, that was me.
Alright, into the next area. So, right after that, we're in the hallway here, or not hallway, the big hall, and, oh, right.
Right, you have I have to stay on it until you press the next button.
Yeah, let me get that. There we go. Now you get that one. Now, first off, you've got that blue stud you see there. That was a minikit originally, but there's also one you have to have a high jumper for. So, that's two in this little area, and we got one more off to the right. Same deal. Oh, sorry, I thought I was on it there. Alright. Now, I hit that one. Yeah, this is actually just how you progress on normally, but you have to jump up to the right to get the minikit. And now we progress to the next spot.
So once you get into the room where you fight Count Dooku, you first head over here... Want to shoot these targets.
Yeah, when you enter the room, it actually shows you a cutscene of the thing showing up. Let's see. Ah, there we go. Got them both together. Get away from us, Dooku. We don't care about you. Now we follow the rest of the arrows. And I build this thing. Get away. Go for it. You can do it. Okay. Think. Okay, we got up there. And now I have to get to the right. I'm gonna fly over there with R2. Oh, wait. I feel stupid. We have to shoot it down. It's not just floating up there. It's actually encased in something.
That would make more sense.
Okay. You know what? I just try to stay near you so you can shoot at it. Let's see. There we go. Now I can fly to it.
Oops, I fell. It's all you.
I got it. I got it. I almost didn't have it. Now we got one last one. Gonna need a high jumper for this. Just come around to the edge. Come around to the left here. And... where's... Oh, it's in the back. Okay. Okay, I can do this.
There we go.
10 of 10. And smack Dooku in the head one more time. Just for good measure. So... shall we see what we got for our last vehicle of... Oh my god, what is this movie called?
Attack of the Clones.
We got... what is... oh! It's Dooku's weird little solar sailor thing.
Yeah, that's kind of lame.
Yeah. But we're getting really close to 100 minikits. Not minikits, 100 gold bricks.
Yep.
Because it said minikit on the screen. That's what threw me off.
All right. Well, we will see you guys next time when we try to find all of the minikits in the third movie, which is...
Revenge of the Sith.
Yeah. It's your fault because you couldn't remember Attack of the Sith. Anyway. Yeah. It's all
my fault.
We hope you've enjoyed this episode, and we will be back later when we are better at talking.
Yes. Maybe after some sleep. We'll see you guys next time.